Welcome back, I'm Laura from Party Friends, nice to see you all again. I'm back again with another balloon modelling tutorial for you today. Now this time, I've gone mad. We're going to be making two designs, okay? I'm going to be making two balloon swords, two different types as well. I'm going completely mad. So this is what we're going to be making today. Balloon swords are brilliant for both kids and adults. Kids and adults alike absolutely love them. You can have hours and hours and hours of amusement out of them. And these two designs are really straightforward to make. They're really basic, easy, and they're really quick as well. So you can just get on with playing with them. You don't have to mess around for too long. So we're gonna be making these today. We have a broadsword, like a knight sword, and we have a cutlass as well, which is a pirate sword. So you can go swashbuckling if you'd like. We're gonna start with the cutlass. For this, you'll need a 260 balloon of any color that you like. I've gone with blue here. So give it a bit of a stretch to start off with. Now for swords, you really don't need much room at the end of your balloon. So you can fill it up as much as possible. I'm talking like a tiny little bit without air right at the end. So it's gonna be a really long balloon. So grab yourself your balloon pump and pump it up. You see at the end there, I have hardly anything left of my balloon for this one. A tiny little amount. Really long balloon. Tie it off at the end. Give it a bit of a squeeze. So, nice long balloon with hardly anything left at the end for the air to go into. So we're going to start here at the tied end. This knot is really important. That's going to be part of your design. So, starting off, you're going to make something called a flower petal. It's generally referred to as a flower petal because it's what you use. You make loads of these when you're creating a balloon flower. So all you have to do at the end with your knot, you just fold it over like that. Make a bit of an N shape long. Don't make it too small because you need the other end of your balloon to fit through the gap. So we're talking a couple of inches long. Make sure there's a bit of a hole in there. Give it a bit of a squeeze to make sure it's nice and flexible, so when you come to put the other end of your balloon through it later on, it'll be much easier. At this point, you're gonna twist this knot into the rest of the balloon. Now, if you've seen the other videos that I've created, you know the best way to create a twist in your balloon is to pinch it. All you have to do is pinch it and then twist. So we're gonna tie this knot into this section of the balloon here. So, taking the knot in your index finger and your thumb, and then wrapping the rest of your hand around it. So you want your third finger here, in between that and your index finger. That was my phone going off. That was really unprofessional of me, wasn't it? Sorry, guys. So, grab the other half of your balloon with your other hand. And then all you need to do is give that a pinch with your index finger and your third finger and twist it round with your other hand. So you can have this kind of effect. So my knot has now been wrapped around the balloon. To make sure that this stays in place, take that knot and push it through the flower petal that you created. Wrap it around, push it through again, wrap it around. Push it through again. This will just make sure that it stays in place so it doesn't come apart on you. There we go. So in the end, you should end up with this weird kind of like an ear effect. And that is all of the stuff that you have to do in terms of twisting. It's really straightforward. Now all you have to do is take this end of your balloon, give it a bit of a squeeze and make sure that the air is filled all the way to the end. So now my balloon is almost completely full. And then you have to take the end and push it through the hole that you've created. Push it all the way through. Keep on going until you reach about a hand's width at the end there. And that's your cutlass handle created. Now I've got a bit of an arc going on here. You just have to give this a bit of a straighten out. A bit of a squeeze, pull in various directions, and there we have it. You have one cutlass created. Ta-da! Really long on this one, but it's great for getting people really far away. You want to bonk someone on the head on the other side of the room. Perfect. Good. So there is your cutlass. Very straightforward for you. Let's get started on our second sword. A broadsword. I'm going to try and balance that over there. There we go. So our broadsword. For this, you will need another 260 balloon, like so. Give it a bit of a stretch. Again, any colour that you like. It's entirely up to you. We're going to do exactly the same as we did earlier on with our cutlass. This time you want slightly more of a gap at the end for your air, but it's around about the same. You're filling it up most of the way. So this is what I've gone for here. Slightly more than I had before, but not very much. We're talking a centimetre or two of a gap at the end there. Tie it off. Starting at the end with your knot, like so, we're going to create a bit of a wave effect, a bit of an S, in fact, with the balloon. So if you fold it over like that, you want this to be about two hands width along. You should be able to fit two hands there. This is going to be the handle and the sides of your cutlass, so this section and this section. So fold it over and then fold it back on itself again. So there we have a bit of a backwards S. And it's, oh, it's awkward. And this is the effect that you should have at the end. So we have a bit of a backwards S going on with three lines of the balloon. Again, it should be, let me just demonstrate this, hold on to everything. It should be about two hands widths in length. It's going to be the handle of your sword and the, I don't know what they're called, the bits that protect your hands on a sword, a bit across the top. I don't know what it's called. It's really terrible with me. Okay, so give it a bit of a squeeze. Make sure that you're sending air through down to the other end. In fact, as you can tell, I've already filled up the end of my balloon there on the other end just from doing this, which is good. So give it a bit of a squeeze. Now in the center here, already sort of create that arch. There we go. So bring your hands into the center of your trio of balloon lines there, your bit of an S, and start to squeeze that section in. You'll notice that I'm starting to create the shape that we want for the handle and the hand guards. Hand guards! That's the name of it. It's called a hand guard, right? I don't know. Okay, so we're already creating the shape of that. Right where my finger and thumbs are in the middle here, that's where the twist is going to happen. So give it a squeeze, and then twist. You really don't even have to do that much of a twist. There we go. Simple as that. Give it a couple more twists if you want, just to make sure it doesn't come apart on you. And there we have our broadsword. So you can go around hitting people with that as well. So that's it, all finished. Two swords there for you, a broadsword and a cutlass, all finished off. Well done. These are brilliant designs, really quick and easy to get you started on some sword balloon modelling. I will be doing a slightly more advanced version of a sword in the near future. This is going to be a more advanced cutlass. It's going to have jewels and everything. So if you've done those and you think, yeah, I can do that, I'd like to do something more advanced, maybe something more fancy, then keep an eye out for that. I will be uploading that in the near future as well. Hit subscribe, because that'll mean that you get notifications of when I upload that in the future. But for now, that is it. So I've got quite an army of swords that I've created. So gather your weaponry together. There we go, lots and lots of different swords there. I could equip a whole army. I'm going to be doing lots of swashbuckling and saving damsels in distress for the rest of the day. So gather your weaponry together. And that's it from me. Hit like, subscribe, comment, everything else. I'd love to see your photos of your creations, maybe photos of you guys doing some sword fighting and that sort of thing with your balloon swords. Thank you very much for joining me. Again, Laura from Party Friends, me and my masses of weaponry here. I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.